hints that Geno might be coming to Smash Ultimate, and we talk some battle quotes.
Blocked content.
What's happening, my Block buddies, and welcome to a brand new episode of Blocked Contents, Leak Speak. My name is Callum, and this is going to be your content for today. Everybody here really wants a certain character in Super Smash Bros. Now, for those of you who know this character, you are going to freak out about this. Geno from Super Mario RPG is, of course, a fan favorite, has been among the tops of the list of, you know, fighters that are very, very well requested for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and it looks like there's a little bit more info in, you know, favor of this character coming to the game. I personally think that it might actually be a very big hint, and I want to talk to you guys about why I think that is. And of course, we got battle quotes going on, which are pre-fight kind of messages between two characters in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Can't wait to talk with you guys about that one. As for those of you guys who like giveaways, we are giving away a beautiful Piranha Plant plushie. And remember to like this video, subscribe to Blocked Content, and comment down below to enter for this giveaway. Alright guys, let's get into this. So, this news has been reported by Papa Geno's other sources, but actually this came to me a few days ago through Geno, which is Geno Star Road Warrior on Facebook, actually reported on this, and I got it sent my way through Matt Banky. So thank you so much for that information. It's really kind of you guys to share this kind of stuff that I'm not privy about, and sometimes I don't think it's very, you know, interesting to make a video about it, and then everybody's talking about it. So I thought it'd be interesting to kind of share my sources about the side of the story, interesting information that I glean from it, and other stuff that's worth talking about with Geno coming potentially to Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. So here, actually saying to me, "Sorry for messaging you again out of the blue. I have something for you to chew on. Are you familiar with the YouTube channel Brawl BRSTMS3X? Well, they basically upload 30-minute extensions of video game music. Recently, though, they've been taking down all, or at least most, of their Nintendo music, because Nintendo is blocking their content." I see what you did there. "This happened before, when they were uploading extensions of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's music before the game came out, and I guess now they're completely cleaning themselves of everything Nintendo to avoid their wrath." So, this is super interesting to me. I've been following this particular thing for a couple of months now, and I really enjoyed the uploads from Brawl BRSTM S3X. I think that it's super fun to have this library of Nintendo music that kind of goes on forever. I mean, 30-minute extensions, it's a lot of fun. Like, if you're gonna, like, learn how to play along with the songs on drums or something like that, it's great to just listen to when you're, you know, doing your homework and stuff like that. So I'm very happy about that channel existing at all. It's a super cool idea, but of course, it, you know, begs the question, is this sort of stuff legal? And I don't really think it is legal. You are essentially posting other people's work with no real, you know, addition to it. You're not, you know, talking over it or reviewing something or remixing it or doing anything with it other than extending it a bit. And, you know, that, of course, is the whole point of it. People want to hear the original thing and they don't just want to go to a game. Sometimes these games don't have soundtracks that come out, so people really want to listen to them. And for that, he's doing God's work. I think it's really, really awesome. However, yeah, it's not necessarily all that legal. And if Nintendo wants to take it down because their content is being used in a way that they don't approve of, they absolutely have that right, and it's kind of, you know, it really makes sense. So it sucks, but it is basically how these things kind of work. Now, this happened before when they were uploading extensions of Smash Bros. Ultimate's music before the game came out, and this is, of course, a very touchy subject. We on Blocked Content here have reported on some news before Smash Ultimate came out, and actually had to be taking those videos down as well. You know, a couple of things that could maybe allude to spoilers, or things that Nintendo really didn't want people to talk about. So that happens, and that's okay. You know, we have a conversation about these things, and then we, you know, change the content around. We are just excited about stuff like this, and we want to talk about stuff like this, and this is the right forum to do it on, but maybe it just wasn't the right time to do it for. Well, now that basically got found out, right? The idea that people are uploading entire bits of music from games, which we love, but yeah, Nintendo really, really doesn't like that at all, and they take them down. as they say, you know, community posts on that YouTube channel go into more detail. And so this Matt Bankey fellow says, so why is that notable now? Well, this page on Facebook originally pointed it out to me. And that page on Facebook is the aforementioned Gino Star Road Warrior. Gino saying, the songs Beware of the Forest Mushrooms and Battle Against an Armed Boss was recently taken down from BRSDM's YouTube channel due to copyright from Nintendo themselves. Probably nothing, but it is odd that those two specific songs out of all of them were taken down. And this is where it gets interesting, right? Because they were those two songs. And those two songs are notable, you know, because they are big, you know, popular songs. They're songs that people know that know the game. But of course, Beware of the Forest Mushrooms is basically kind of Gino's theme. It's the theme that people really feel like is Super Mario RPG's anthem, is kind of Gino's main, you know, main jam. So that's interesting, right? He says, apparently, Brawl BRSDM S3X had removed two songs from their Super Mario RPG Legend of the Seven Stars collection, Beware of the Forest Mushrooms, and Fight Against an Armed Boss. So Nintendo taking those two specifically out? That's strange, right? Not getting rid of the lot, but just saying these two were probably going to do something with this. So he says this feels notable in that despite Super Mario RPG technically being a Mario game, the IP for the game itself, which includes the characters and I would also assume the music, is owned by Square Enix. And as you can see, all non-Nintendo game music extensions are still intact on their channel. So stuff that isn't, you know, Nintendo bound, they have no, you know, no fuss over at all. So, some have speculated that this means that Nintendo has plans to use those two songs in a Nintendo game in the near future. Maybe, perhaps, in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate? Perhaps the two songs will be part of a future DLC update that, maybe a certain possessed wooden puppet becomes a playable character. Now, obviously, that doesn't confirm anything, and even if the songs are going to be in Super Smash Ultimate, that doesn't necessarily mean that Gino also will be. That said, he recalls a situation earlier this year where Loot Crate teased and showed support for Banjo-Kazooie in Super Smash Bros. While advertising a Loot Crate themed that included Banjo-Kazooie goodies. And not only was their original tweet removed, they also lost out on the Banjo-Kazooie memorabilia they were going to include. Some people speculated that they teased something they weren't supposed to, or they accidentally broke a non-disclosure agreement regarding Banjo-Kazooie in Super Smash Bros. And since we now know that Banjo-Kazooie are in fact in Smash Bros., well, all we're saying is it's probably something worth keeping in mind, and this is super interesting to me. So there's a couple of points here to hit that make sense, right? It makes sense for Nintendo just to remove songs, to not be at all hinting at anything, and it makes sense for it to be stuff from a Mario game, right? But this is interesting. The part where it's basically Square Enix stuff, right? They, I think, own the rights to this stuff. That to me is interesting, although they did use the theme in Super Smash Bros. For Wii U and 3DS in a video, right? It's a video where the Gino Mii costume showed up, and it was like, Smash Bros. And Super Mario RPG, Legend of the Seven Stars, oh, here we go. So they have been using it. But they have also been working with Square Enix for a certain Cloud character in Smash Bros. So, yeah, there are already partnerships there, so we will never really know if it's Nintendo-owned or not. Now, what could have happened behind the scenes is that Nintendo has the rights back to everything that was in Super Mario RPG, that some sort of agreement was either always in place and some characters they just don't want to talk about or, you know, don't want to include anymore, or that they've recently settled this and now all the music in the game belongs to Nintendo, all the characters in the game finally belong to Nintendo again too. It's not this weird two-way split where, you know, sometimes they can kind of use Gino in, you know, Mario and Luigi kind of remake thing, and sometimes they can't when the Mario and Luigi game gets remade. It's super strange, and we don't really have a clear answer, but this seems to point towards Nintendo having the rights over at least those two songs, right? Beware of the Forest Mushrooms can't be taken down by Nintendo if they don't own the song. So that to me says that Geno is also a character that Nintendo now owns, which would make it sort of a first-party character. Now, of course, it still has roots in this third-party madness, which to me makes it a little more curious, right? Will we see Geno in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate is the ultimate question here, and what I think I glean from this is that this is actually a big hint towards it being real. I think that, in my mind, the Fighter Pass characters are just all third-party characters. I've said that from the start, and I'll say it again. I think that the Grinch League had sort of the right idea with adding a couple of characters that fans have wanted for a very long time. Of course, the Grinch League turned out to be super fake, but we did manage to get Banjo-Kazooie, and then we did manage to get Ken in the game also. So that's super interesting to me to think about Geno, who was also in that, you know, fake league. And Geno, of course, is a character that people have wanted for a while, and is also associated as being a third-party kind of character, and that being why it's difficult to include the character in Smash Brothers. This seems to be a step in favor of Geno, right? And not just getting his spirit in the game, because we know it's in there, but maybe getting it as a character. I mean, the Mii costume for Geno was great, and probably sold really well, and isn't in the game at all. So there's a couple of things here lining up for me, and that's that I think the characters need to be third-party. Geno kind of is, because he was created by a third-party, not necessarily belongs to a third-party right now, but is created by it. And I think that along with those two songs getting taken down, maybe Nintendo wants to make sure that they, you know, own those songs, and they show that they own those songs before the big trailer hops that basically says, yeah, winter or whatever, we're gonna get Geno in the game. I think that Geno would be a great choice for fans, but I think there are other characters that would make a lot more sense in terms of getting more audience to Smash Brothers. You know, characters like Crash to rep some Sony stuff, and characters like Ryu Hayabusa for the Eastern audiences, I think would make sense. Those are my two picks. Whenever people ask me about it, it's like the final two. Yeah, Crash and Hayabusa, I think would you know, fit the right, tick the right boxes. But Geno throws me for a loop, because I think it fits that category of it being King K. Rool, Banjo-Kazooie, Ridley territory, where it's like, fans have wanted this character, Sakurai knows it, it's the whole Mii costume thing all over again. I could see the trailer now, you know, in the forest with Geno saving Mario, Bowser, and Peach or something like that. It's going to be incredible, and I really think that it could be happening in this game. If it's going to happen in any game, it's going to be Ultimate, because that's Ultimate's moniker. It's like making dreams come true. And, you know, this is the Star Boy, right? This is the Starro Warrior. I mean, it's no wonder that we're going to get this character if it's all about dreams, you know, coming true. And I think that Geno would make sense in the game. I think that there is a lot of moveset potential for the character, and if you have any ideas for that moveset, I really want to see them in the comments below, because I'm curious what you guys think Geno should look like, you know, how tall he should be, what he should move like, what his taunt should be, and his final smash and stuff like that. I'm really curious if you guys have any ideas about that. Now, there's one more topic that I really wanted to talk with you guys about, and that's the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate battle quotes, which are basically pre-fight conversations between two characters that are chosen for a match. This is a brand new show from Blocked Content, and we're going to be doing a whole lot of episodes about this, and we already got a lot of them in the can. We have a cast of over 40 actors who are giving life to these characters, and it's all original animation. Everything is recreated, and all the voices are, of course, recreated. It's original scripts, and the idea here is to have it be sort of like a fighting game like Mortal Kombat, or I think Dragon Ball fighting games used to do it back in the day. Soul Calibur did it. And it's, if you choose two characters to fight and that little loading screen pops up, those two characters will actually have original dialogue between the two of them talking together. And the first episode we have out is Palutena versus Lucario. And I really want to ask you guys to watch that one, because if you guys like the series, we're going to be putting out a whole lot more of them. And everyone in the comments has already, you know, let me know all the different combinations that they want to hear, because there's so much rich history between the characters, or so many great things that they could still explore together. So I hope you guys are curious, and I hope you guys look forward to more episodes of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's battle quotes. And I just want to give a big shout out to the entire cast of the show that's helping me realize this very fun little parody Easter egg. So that was it for Blocked Content today. I want to head it over to our comment question of the day, and our comment question is, do you think Geno will be in the Fighter's Pass. Let me know in the comments down below, because your comment could be featured in our next Blocked Content video. As for our previous comment question, the answer is Ryan Miller saying, I'm going to totally be getting this, so I can use my main Switch for the TV, and when I come home from college every other weekend, and then use the Switch Lite for my time in college. I'm definitely going to wait for the Pokemon Sword and Shield version though, gotta rep that red and blue, you know? So Ryan Miller here is talking about the newly revealed Nintendo Switch Lite, which looks great, and I actually really want to get the thing when it comes out, because I have a similar thing where it's like, I'm in different places sometimes, and I really want to get one for on the go, I really want to get one for on the TV, and I don't want to, you know, take that one for the TV everywhere, you know, in fear that it won't get, you know, crushed or whatever. So I really get this idea, but also the Switch Lite just looks cool, so I think I'm gonna get it. So thank you so much for commenting. These things are always a ton of fun to go through. And of course, a very big shout out for everyone joining on Patreon. You guys make it possible for me to just sit in the studio, talk about video games all day. And that means the world to me. You guys gotta know it. So if you wanna be a part of the channel, donate something to become a part of the discussion, or have your own ideas animated by me, you know, you can have your own battle quotes, actual theories put in there, and I can actually make a video about them. Go to patreon.com/blockedcontent, because there's a bunch of incredible rewards there, and they're waiting just for you. And remember, if you're not yet a member of the Blocked Content family yet, you can do that by clicking that subscribe button and ring that bell for notifications, so every time we make a video, it'll hop and pop up right there on your screen. And also, remember to give this video a like, a little thumbs up, so click that thumbs up button, and you'll make me a whole lot of happy in a whole little time. Anyways, thank you guys so much. All the news and fun you care about will be delivered daily to you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys around the corner, where there's always more battle quotes, and of course, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, Leak Speak, and Blocked Content. I'll see ya.